Good afternoon, I believe it is now, Sarah. We are at a stone renovation project just outside.
Very nice one.
Yeah, very nice one. Maças and Dona Maria at a really attractive price.
Yeah. So this property, the boundary is here. And it goes round to probably the building. You can see there's just like a 3 meter gap and you can see there's a building there. There is the neighbour on the other side, but I imagine you close that gap.
Well, there's no neighbour, there's a house.
No, there's a house that they don't want to sell, so it's not going anywhere fast.
Yeah.
Just to get you see the extent of the build here. So with my measuring, it was 21 metres.
I mean, she has got quite short legs, but...
Do I have to like do a long stride?
No, we'll call it 21 metres.
Well, it's 21 metres.
And so it's 110 square metres all in all, because it's got a width of 5.
Yeah, you've got to take into account
the
stone walls. On the inside, you lose some of that. But when you come down here, actually, you get a glimpse of the views that you've got from the back of the property. So this would all be the back of the property.
Yeah, I'm just going to pan back.
Am I in the way?
No, you're not in the way at all. I'm just going to pan back, Sarah.
Yes.
So we have a look at the house from the other direction.
Yeah.
Okay, this is just garden wall with this block or tijolo topping.
Yeah, with another... Actually, look at that. That fig hasn't got any... That tree hasn't got any figs on, but the in the garden...
Rascally tree. I'm just going to take in these views.
They've got a very, very, very pretty water tank down
they
here.
They have. I was looking at that.
Have you been and had a look, have you?
Yeah.
It's absolutely huge. We might have to do a little show you. But for now, let's focus on the house. But
the views are spectacular. I mean, it's not the best of days, but...
I think it's perfect. It's not boiling hot. And it's
it's very nice. It's just like, you know...
And it's not raining. We've got an in-between.
For the video purposes, the light is less than perfect.
So the land plot... I'm guesstimating at about 1,500. So this would be your main entrance.
Yeah.
There's the driveway cut in, so I imagine you'd use that. And
yeah, but equally as easily you could have the driveway put in so it goes directly up there. So you can make quite a wide entrance, and the driveway would skirt the edge of the property, wouldn't it?
Yeah, or you could just make it loop all the way around and do whatever you want.
Yeah, I know, but I mean, you know, that'd be silly, wouldn't it?
Well, that's something quite nice about a sweeping round out, by the way.
Yeah, okay.
If you want a sweep, even he didn't agree with me.
If you're a sweepy round driveway type person, you can do that.
We have quite a long driveway, darling. Right. So, the edge of the property is really quite clear because it's this level.
Yeah, it's the road.
Oh, don't stand there.
Yeah, this soil is very, very diggable, isn't it?
Yeah, good soil. Very, very soft soil.
Yeah, another thing this, apart from views, another thing this area is famous for is water. It's always, the wells have always got water in, and often you can actually hear them running, you know.
I've got another one to put up for sale. Oh, stupid dog. In this area that's got 3 water mines on it.
Wow. Yeah.
So the boundary here, I mean, look at the views from here. And this is your back garden. The house is just behind Paul. Well, probably about 20 metres behind Paul.
Yeah, well, Paul's looking at the views at the moment.
Yeah, I know.
So, but I mean, I will just say, you know, I mean, Sarah just mentioned we've got another house to put on with 3 water mines. And if you do want to stay up to date and not miss any, please do like the video and subscribe to the channel.
I mean, I'll say that the other one is a complete ruin. This is a renovation job.
Yeah.
So completely different properties. It's just that this area has lots and lots of natural water mines. They're quite incredible to see. You've just got this hole in the wall and water comes out.
Water gushes out of it, yeah.
And so we're just sort of tramping around the garden. We've got lots of established, quite large olive trees, old olive trees. That one's got 4 trunks. And that's the large Nespera. We've got a cabbage. Everyone's got to have a cabbage.
Yeah.
We haven't had any cabbages for a while.
It's like almost illegal not to have a cabbage, isn't it? I mean, we are actually walking up the boundary, aren't we?
Yes, we are, because you can see the difference in where it's been cleared. Oh, no, we're not.
No, we're not.
No, we're not. This is the boundary about here.
Yeah, Sarah's on the boundary.
I'm on the boundary because it's about, they cleared a couple of metres extra.
Yeah.
And as we go up, you'll find the very special rock which tells us exactly where the boundary is. So.
Which obviously could never be moved.
No. Spent 16 years going by rocks and tree lines. Right, here is your rock. Incredibly special rock. This is your boundary marker.
Yeah.
And from
Sarah's foot.
Close.
That ultra clear little grey rock, which we couldn't find at all when she was trying to tell me about it earlier.
Right, so from here, if you go across to there,
yeah.
I'll walk it.
Yeah, I think that's best.
Because it doesn't quite go to the end of the building.
No. They are what they are.
See, there's no rock here.
No, but it's about...
But everyone knows it's about here.
It's about there.
Right. And then, so that's not... This, the building is.
The building is, yeah.
Land's not. And then I'm going to... Oh, there's another cabbage. Right, I'm going that way.
I mean, you could make a big sweeping driveway and turn that into a garage, actually.
You could do that. Oh, look, I'm saving a cabbage now. Don't really know how I'm going to do that.
Oh.
Oh, well, why I'm doing it.
No, me neither.
Right.
Can we stop doing that?
I'll just put the cabbage down, shall I?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll put the cabbage down. Right, okay.
I think that's a good idea.
Not sure what they put. Underneath there is stone. Oh, look. Oh, do you know what? If I had the money to put it down, I would do it. Walnut tree. Huge one. They are absolutely fabulous shade givers.
Don't think the walnut tree's for sale.
Walnut tree included. And then you've got an orange tree. And another orange tree.
Yeah, if we could afford to be flipping houses, I think both agree we'd be doing this one.
This one got little tiny oranges on it.
Yeah.
And this one has got big oranges on it. They're different varieties of oranges and clementines or whatever. So these are probably going to be ready about Christmas time.
Well, a little bit after, yeah. Yeah.
And then they are going to be a bit later.
Well, they might just be clementines and not just...
They might be.
Yeah.
Clementines around, they're winter fruit,
yeah,
aren't they?
They are.
That's another fig. So hang on, let's come this way to the to the well.
I mean, you can eat them at Christmas, but they're a little bit sweeter a month or two later, usually.
Well, to be honest, every single one, like these fig trees must be different from the one over there. There's no fruit on them.
Yeah.
The one over there has got figs like this. I've just
they are
about
big,
five of them.
They are big.
Which, considering I always thought I didn't like figs, it's a bit... This year I'm eating lots of figs. Right. And have you got glasses on?
I have. I don't know what that's got to do with anything, but I have.
Well, no, because if you look in the well, knowing you, you'll drop your glasses.
Well, no, obviously I'm not going to do that.
Clearly. And you're just going to... Look how deep that is. I mean, I hate looking in wells, but look at that. That's really spectacular.
Yeah, I don't know what it's going to...
Can you see? You must be right. You've got it now.
Yeah.
Water in.
Yeah, it is.
Still the old wiring for the, whatever you call this thing here. And the pines growing around it. And another huge nest. But I mean, this would be such a lovely, lovely garden. And I've got those clear views from here.
Yeah.
Straight from here.
Well, I'll get round there and show that.
Yeah.
Oh,
look, this is the old tank that obviously used to pump into the tank. And this would have been a holding tank as well.
Yeah, that would have been a later addition sort of holding tank, wouldn't it?
And here is actually a stone wall as well. And I have always wondered whether you could include that in the footprint.
I think you probably almost certainly could, but I can't guarantee it. What we can guarantee is all of this here.
Right. So this is the back of the bread oven. Shall I stay or shall I go now?
Yeah, I'm just gonna show that you can actually see the views from underneath this covered terrace area.
Ah, it's not me forgetting my words, it's him. Right, so this is the outside of the... We'll come back and go in, shall we? Because this is... You can see there's a door there, there's a door there, there's a window here. Now it's actually separated inside, and these would have just been outbuildings. obviously it's all stone and you just interlink it.
Yeah, should we kind of go to the end?
Yep.
We can show the other little 7x3, 21 square metre building that does belong, which is this here.
Which obviously goes much further back than you can see. It's just got a wooden...
Yeah.
Actually, if you come here...
Got a shuttery thing on the end
of it. You can see the length of the stone. The stone means everything because it means it can be rebuilt. It exists. It could be legalised.
Yeah, Sarah has been to the town hall and checked on this particular property, haven't you?
Yeah, because this property is not registered at the moment.
Yeah.
So we don't often put these up. There's loads of them all over Portugal.
Yeah.
But we don't often put them for sale. But this is such... The owner wants to sell. I've been to the town hall and checked with the engineers. So I go to the town hall. We get the maps out. I show them where the house is. And they put all the different layers on. And it shows you what's urban and what isn't and what can be built. So this, it's stone. And it's in an urban area. This can be legalised and turned to habitation, no problem whatsoever. Otherwise, if I didn't know that and I hadn't been myself, I wouldn't be putting it out.
Yeah.
Now I'm going to talk figs, okay? Look at this baby.
They are whoppers, aren't they?
Aren't they?
I just had to wash my hands. She just had to wash them because she's been troughing on the figs. Ugh. This was clearly the old...
Oh, this one isn't ripe.
Oh.
It's that big and it's not ripe. And this is your old Adega. Have you got any
light on? Yeah, I'm trying to get a bit more.
You probably really do need to bring a torch, don't we?
Well, a torch wouldn't help. The wrong
might
kind.
Help me.
Yeah, it might help you.
Actually, look at the stone.
Definitely wouldn't. Yeah.
Go behind you.
Yeah, it's very noisy, darling. The picture, that everything's eating the light.
Okay, all right. The stones behind him were amazing. I hadn't seen them before.
Yeah, I probably saw them, but it's just not great.
Okay. Right.
Now, here you can see.
So here stones. You can get through.
It could all be exposed like this.
Oh, look, there's the old electricity. No, look. So you wouldn't really be much hassle opening it up.
No, there'd be no trouble whatsoever. There was an old doorway. I spotted that, yeah. Just 1 second. Let me go rushing. Yeah, sorry about the video quality. I know this is going to be a bit noisy, but it's...
Why is it going to be noisy?
It means speckly. There's lots of little speckles. It's called noise. Yeah, there was a doorway through there which could easily be reopened just there. So that would link up to the rest of the house. A couple of hours with a hammer. And you've joined up the entire place.
Very easily. Now, that one's... We'll go through the other door. Now, this, you can see the width of your stone. And look, the old latches.
Slotty thingies for the doors, yeah.
Oh. Were we doing keys yesterday?
Yeah.
Enormous keys yesterday, didn't we? I love them. And they're always going upside down, by the way.
Not always, but most of the time.
Most of the time, upside down and turn the wrong way around.
Yeah.
Just to be slightly bonkers. So, this has obviously been joined at a later date, but this is the old kitchen. Now, you're going to have, it's really dark in here. Ever so slightly sooty. I don't think the chimney worked very well. But
no, it was too high, wasn't it?
Yeah, our old house was like this, wasn't it? Oh my God, look, the chimney's really tall.
Yeah, our old house never had a chimney. They just lit the fire next to the wall.
Oh, yeah. So how have they managed to get it so black?
No, because this...
Isn't working.
Yeah, touch this, Sarah. Yeah. This. Touch it. Just touch it. That there is too high. The later ones, they were lower.
Oh, that's why you always hit your head on them.
Yeah, that's why you always hit the hit your head on the other ones.
Bread, oh my God, what's in it?
But they don't... But they don't... Oh.
I want to know what's in the bread oven, but I'm scared.
Well, it's just a hole, darling, isn't
it? It's something.
No, it's not. Look.
Oh, there's actually a dead rat.
Oh, there is a dead rat. Sorry, folks.
Dead rat and a bit of metal. Well,
right,
okay. Hang on a minute. No, you've not finished. You've got to
come back.
Well, I'm sorry. There's
anything. No, I didn't. It's
just very, very dark. We can't see anything. Stick your camera. Right, don't fall down. There's another space here.
Yeah, I don't need to come in it. I can
basically a dungeon.
So yeah, as we go through this entrancey hall, you can see the quality of the stone and the thickness of the walls. I mean, you know, you could make three, but with good sizes, it's 4 meters. It's over.
Well, I get it. It's 5 meters inside.
Okay.
That was from the door, though.
Yeah.
So you've taken out that much.
Yeah, but it's a decent size, isn't it? You get at least.
I mean,
in modern, with modern dimensions of rooms, at least 3 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms, didn't you?
Yeah, it's.
You'd probably, renew the roof, leave it vaulted, so you get lots of roof height.
Yeah, I mean, the only, you've got from this stone wall until the end, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's just call it 7. 7 meters from stone wall to stone wall.
Yeah.
Isn't that the one we said there was an old doorway? So there's an old doorway around here, isn't there?
Yeah.
On this side.
It goes into that.
So that's a 7 by 4 meter big space, which would be, that's a good size kitchen and diner, for example.
Yeah.
Bedrooms at either end or something like that. I mean.
Yeah.
Plenty of light coming in these sides. So, although clearly this needs to come out, it's a really, really well situated, very, very nice renovation project.
No, it's a cracker.
You just rip the roof off. And
for the money, fantastic, really.
Yeah, really good. Yeah, I really quite like it. I should have put it for sale a while ago, to be honest.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, money doesn't just happen to fall in our hands. There we go. So, yeah, the views, it's really peaceful. Shall we finish by the fig tree?
If you want to.
There's an orange here.
You're dying to get your hands on another fig, aren't you?
Well, no, we've got. But the thing is, established flowers here. I tried to grow these. They just pop up. Look, they're all coming out. The flowers there. Flowers here. Flowers here. Flowers here. It's one of those that used
they're
to be.
They're very pretty. I like those a lot.
Used to be planted up, so a bit of love and care. That's a peach tree or something, that is.
Yeah.
That Nespera's enormous.
That is one big loquat.
We've got really, really nice variety of trees, and this would make a very nice garden. Maybe I'll come here. So, I think in summary, very peaceful, kind of at the end of the village. I happen to know that there are 2 more houses down there on the left, quite a little way down, and that's it, it's the end of the road. And yet you're probably 7 minutes into the centre of Macedonia Maria.
Okay.
Where they have, there's a creche and a school and a pharmacy and cafes and a cafe that does take away lunches and everything. There's a market. And then Alvaiazere is realistically 15 minutes, I think. 12 to 15.
I don't know. You've done it a lot more recently than I have.
Yes, it's something like that. So, thank you for watching. I hope you like the property as much as we do. And I'll see you next time. Please do like and subscribe.
Ciao.
Bye.